Alright guys, welcome back to Reaver Show. I know it's been a while, but here we finally are. So without further ado, let's get into it. Today we'll be checking out the Hudson AirTech Pro. It's an air rifle, chambered in 5.5mm or 0.22. So, let's start by opening the box. Alright, there she is. As usual, we'll start off with the manual. Yeah, it's your basic Hudson manual. Just some general information about air guns and, in general. Not specific this type of air rifle, but just overall the the rules and safety concerns, etc. Nothing too special. Alright, so here she is, the Hudson AirTech Pro. Like already mentioned, it's chambered in 0.22 or 5.5mm. I could say it's pretty much a budget air gun. But I have to say, what I've seen from it so far, I think it's a very, very decent piece, especially for its price point. It comes in at 800 FPS, or 245 meters per second, so that's pretty decent for 22, especially for an air rifle, it's pretty decent. The power comes in at 30 joules, or 22 foot-pounds, so yeah, that's decent, that's not too bad. The weight on it is 2600 grams. That's 5.7 lbs, and the overall length comes in at 114 centimeters or 44 inches, with a barrel length of 37 centimeters or 14 inches. Alright, let's start off by checking out some of the trademarks. Here on top you have your Hudson logo, Hudson AirTech, and here on the side on the breech, I don't know if you can see it, but it says the caliber 0.22 or 5.5mm with the serial number of this rifle. The gun itself is fully constructed out of enforced polymer. Usually I ain't a big fan of polymer, especially on air rifles, because they tend to have a little bit they have some recoil on it. So polymer wouldn't be my go-to, but I have to say it's very, very decent. Like I said, this gun retails for, here in Europe, around $100. And I saw that even in the US it goes for as low as 50 or 60 bucks, so yeah, you couldn't expect any crazy quality or anything, but I have to say, it's very decent. It's really, really solid. Now, the rear sight is a true glow sight. It goes as well for the front sight. It's adjustable in windage and in height, of course. The front sight is unfortunately fixed. You have a little screw to replace the fiber in it, but it isn't adjustable or anything. I have to say, it's made out of polymer as well, but yeah. It's a decent polymer. It's not like some cheap plastic. They did a pretty good job on there. I have to say it's a little bit, it's not too sturdy, but I mean for 100 euros, you shouldn't expect anything crazy. Now, the trigger board, it's as well unfortunately a polymer trigger, but it's hard polymer. It's adjustable. It's a two-stage trigger, so you can adjust it to your needs and your likes. So that's pretty decent. On top of the gun, you have a dovetail rail and a Picatinny rail. So that's pretty nice. That's something rather new on air rifles. So no matter what size is, 11mm or 22mm, your scope or red dot will fit on this gun. Now on this gun, of course, you have a safety. It has an ACS, otherwise known as an automatic cocking system. That just typically means if you break the barrel, it automatically cocks your safety, but of course you can do it as well manual. Just pull this little lever back. Right now, as you can see, you don't see any color. That means safe. What if you pushed in? I don't know if you can see it, but yeah, it shows here a little red dot. That means it's not safe, of course. Now, if you move to the back of the gun, here's your stock with a pistol grip. It's pretty decent grip, I have to say. I'm personally not a big fan of this type of pistol grip, or this type of grip in general, because as you can see, if you grab the gun and you want to fire the gun, because of this hole right here, you automatically pull the gun a little bit to the side, which can make it a little bit less accurate. Here is your buttstock. It's a rubber buttstock. I have to say it absorbs some decent amount of the shock, because it's a brake barrel. Of course it has a decent punch to it, so this is a nice addition to it. Now, here we see the rail for the gun. Like I already mentioned, it's dovetail and Picatinny, so no matter what scope you have, it will fit on it. I was planning to put a scope on it, like a 4x32 or anything like that. But because I noticed something, and that is that the real part is not directly on the chamber where the spring is located. So it's like, yeah, inside of the polymer. So that's pretty nice. So that means the scope doesn't take the full amount of recoil from the spring. So that's why I bought a red dot on it. It worked perfectly fine. No problems with the glass breaking or anything like that. So that's a very nice feature to have. It's not like a SAS, like a shock absorbing system or yeah, so anything fancy, but this will do as well. So that's a nice thing. Now, if you move to the front of the gun, here's your barrel with the suppressor. It's a real working suppressor, so that's pretty nice. I read on the Hudson site that it reduces about 30% of the noise the gun makes. Of course, you will still have the noise from the spring going back and forth, but that's something you just can't reduce. So it's nice that they added this to make it a little bit quieter. I've shot it around 200 times right now, and I have to say it's a pretty loud gun. Especially for brake barrel, it's very, very loud. But I think, yeah, without the suppressor on it, it will be even worse. So it's a nice addition. Also, inside of here is the barrel, but it's fully covered with this polymer. Could be a downside, you think, but it's actually pretty decent, because now you don't have to get your dirty hands on the barrel every time. So no chance for rust or anything, or just damaging your barrel in general, because it's all protected by this polymer. Now, I have to say, the gun is pretty accurate, even with a red dot, not like a scope or anything, just a pretty basic red dot. It performs very, very decent. I shoot from around 50 feet, and it's all centered in like this big of a circle. So that's pretty decent. Also, it has some real power, I have to say. I've shot it at some wooden planks, and it goes through 4 centimeters of wood, so that's like 1.5 inch. So that's pretty decent for an air rifle. I have to say, normally for an air rifle, around the 100 euro range, you shouldn't be expecting anything crazy. Just some basic air rifle, just shoot pellets, but that's basically it. But I have to say, that's not the case with this gun. Even it's Hudson, so Hudson is usually a pretty high quality air rifles, and I think they performed really well on this one, especially for the price range they have. For with those prices, and then put out a gun like this, I think that's a good job. Unfortunately, I'm not going to shoot a gun right now in this video, because it's already night right here, and I don't think my neighbors will appreciate it. So we'll save them the hassle. But overall, I have to say, if you want a nice budget air gun, just something not expensive, just something you can shoot in your garden, etc. Even some pest control, because this gun is more than capable of taking out like rats or mice or anything like that, just small game. It's no problem for this rifle. So if you're looking for just a budget air rifle, I think this is a really decent piece. Especially it's high quality. All the metal parts, etc. are covered in polymer, so no worries about getting rust or anything. So for this price point, I would highly recommend this rifle. Now, thank you guys for watching. I hope you liked this video, and I'll see you in the next.